Okay, packing up orders. Hope you're doing good. This book sold for $139 plus shipping to an international buyer. And I'm thinking, how do I get more sales like that? I had about 30 sales this weekend. Average sale price around 25 bucks. But if I could do 30 sales with an average sale price of 140 bucks, that's some pretty good revenue. And on top of that, I only paid 50 cents for this book. Interestingly enough, it was an Amazon book. I bought this in like 2017 on a pallet of books, and I paid like 50 cents for it. If you remember the warehouse bulk book series over there, we were just doing pallets of bulk books. Kind of too expensive freight-wise for that now. But I'm still, you know, as you saw last week, buying pallets of DVDs. But this book, though, what leads to sales like this? Well, I think there are three things, three essential skills that are going to help any business make more money online. And I'm just going to kind of frame it in the from the perspective of resale. But anyone who sells stuff, you're going to want to do these things. And the first thing is you want to be curious. When I saw this title, Principles of Extractive Metallurgy, Pyrometallurgy. So it's burning metal to get metal out of metal, I guess. It's really old. I'd say from the 80s or 70s, but that doesn't matter. What year is it from? 1985. Right there, you can tell. It's from 1985, and most textbooks from 1985 are garbage, not worth anything. Throw them away. But this one is not. Why? Well, because people have been metallurgying for centuries. Whenever you can find something that people have been enamored with or have become, has arisen, their curiosity has been, it makes them curious. Whenever you can see things that people have been wanting to do for a long time, like metallurgy, a lot of older math books, things about carpentry, you know, from scratch, hewn wood and everything, you're gonna probably have a good textbook, even if it's very old. I sold a book on antique watch repair, or rather an antique book on watch repair for 40 bucks, another international buyer. And when I say you have to be curious, you have to go, okay, that seems interesting. That's not, you know, some pop psychology garbage textbook about how kids with pets are better socialized in commune living arrangements. No, that's garbage. This is not garbage. This is real. This is a real thing people want. Going to a buyer in the Netherlands, paid a lot of money for it because it's going international too. So the first C is curiosity. What's the second C? The second C is you have to be creative. You have to go, okay, someone wants this. How can I get it to them? Creative not isn't like, oh, I'm a great ballet dancer, or I'm very funny, or I do a really good Richard Dreyfuss impression. No, creative as in I see a problem, I solve the problem. Here's the problem I have. I have a book I gotta sell. So I first listed it on Amazon. That was not the right approach. After about a year or two of it being FBA, I took it off eBay or off Amazon and put it on eBay. I probably could have cross-posted on ABE Books and Etsy, but I didn't because at the time I didn't know. This was, you know, on the back of my head. I listed it years ago. I forgot about it, and when that sale came in, I was pretty excited. And that's why I got to thinking about this. How can I have more of these? And so creative. Think of it from the buyer's perspective. If you want to learn this skill, if you want to create stuff with metal, with fire and metal, where can you get that stuff? More importantly, what keywords do they want to use to find the things? Because you want to use those keywords. And so I just said metallurgy, put the person's last name. I put what the other books in the series are called. Just anything I can do to get a lot of traffic. And this book only had about, I don't know, probably 15 views over the past however long they track views for. It was on the bottom of my view count. But it still sells because with stuff like this, maybe you're going to sell one every 3 years, but the buyer absolutely needs it, absolutely wants it. And the third thing is you got to be consistent. So when I find this book, I understand what it is I need, what makes it valuable, how to sell it, how to list it, how to ship it. Now, I have to be consistent in that. What I've been doing over the past few months, and this book is just part of that consistency, is twice a week I go around to a few thrift stores that I know get lots of textbooks, and I don't go to the textbook with the barcodes. If they look really new, I'll scan those, but I'm going to the textbooks and the old religious books, and all of just the old books that have some sort of nonfiction element to them. They're textbooks, they're trade books. There's a lot of words for them. And I look those titles up because that's the kind of thing that people are passing on. And if I can consistently figure out how to find high-value, non-barcode textbooks like this, then I'll turn this one sale a weekend. I probably sell 5 textbooks a month like this for this kind of profit to hopefully 1 or 2 a day. And 1 or 2 a day from 5 a month, that's an enormous upgrade. And the only way I'm gonna do it is by both consistently listing things, but also consistently sourcing things, looking for books like this. And as I find better sourcing options for them, pursuing those options with my same process, my same skill set, the same everything. And if you can do that, if you can be curious about finding new leads, creative about getting ways to make these leads monetized, to get them into someone's hands, the item you're trying to sell, and consistently do that, you're gonna make a lot of money doing anything online selling wise. I mean, I can't think of a thing that can't do well with this. Thanks for watching. I'm Blake. Hope you have a good resale business. Talk about it in the comments. I want to know what you're doing, and I'll see you guys later.